Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife. Today on Destiny Master at Arms, we're going to be taking a new direction. Whilst we'll still remain within the bounds of the Crucible, instead of looking at a playstyle or class, today we're going to be looking at something very different. An entire subclass of weapons. Namely, auto rifles. Auto rifles, of course, are primary weapons, and you'll be able to unlock them at every single stage of rarity. The game starts you out with an auto rifle, and it's one of the most commonly used weapons in the Crucible as of the beta. Keep in mind that this may change given pulse rifles and hand cannons are getting a buff, but auto rifles are still a strong contender in mid to close ranges in the Crucible. This guide will inform you on everything to do with auto rifles, but keep in mind that specific weapons that you may want builds for are going to be used in separate videos, and I'm going to upload those at a later date given that I have not got my hands on the weapons yet. Having said that, there's a lot that I can say about auto rifles from simply having used a few in the beta. So let's jump in with that immediately, and state that auto rifles will work in mid to close ranges. You shouldn't necessarily be looking to use these at long ranges given that you will get outperformed by scout rifles and even pulse rifles. The mid-range itself is risky as well. Hand cannons dominate, fusion rifles can be tricky, and of course there's the ever-prominent threat of the buffed pulse rifles themselves. But all of this does not necessarily put a point against using an auto rifle. The main strength of an auto rifle is consistency. And this is something that this weapon truly can pride itself on. There is nothing that an auto rifle can't hit several times, assuming that it is within the effective ranges that you want to use it within. The design for an automatic rifle dates back to pre-Golden Age tech. In the 20th and 21st century, innovations began on weapons that could be fired in full automatic modes, instead of the traditional one-shot rifle that then had to be reloaded. This design has been improved gradually and systems have begun to become smoother and smoother, until current day technology allows us to have mag rails with magazines that no longer need to stack ammunition vertically. This means that a variety of different ways of loading your weapon are possible, but despite all of this, the auto rifle has kept to one sleek form, with a mag loaded from the bottom. Other weapon characteristics include much more customizable frames than previously. Golden Age and pre-Golden Age tech did not necessarily use plasteel, but in the city's move to create more durable weapons that could be picked up off dead guardians and forces of the city individuals, there was a need to cover such weapons in plating. But this has not changed much. The weapons are still highly customizable, even with their internal systems being able to be subject to some modification. There is no question, auto rifles are popular in the wild today, and it's easy to pick up and learn how to use one. Next up, though, let's think about some different ways in which you can subcategorize auto rifles. Now keep in mind, these are not official designations. They are simply ways in which you can look at the weapons and how they generally work out. First of all, let's talk about point defense weapons. Now, these auto rifles tend to have a much higher rate of fire, but with this, they get lower damage due to the smaller cartridges that they will fire. With this higher rate of fire and even higher ammunition capacity, one has to consider the biggest drawback of using a point defense weapon, which is the enormous recoil that one can attain from these. Unless they have the correct perks, such as Rodeo, it's nearly impossible to control these weapons. But if fired from the hip, occasionally you can find one that really does shine. Multi-role weapons, on the other hand, bridge the gap between the point defense weapons and the slower firing carbine-like rifles. These tend to have high ammunition capacity as well, but their damage is also moderate. The high rates of fire are maintained, and so is some recoil, although admittedly these are much easier to control. The damage itself is at a good ratio with the rate of fire, and this makes multi-role rifles such as the Shingen C and the silvered Hushwind D, Shadow Price and more, even more popular than the ones that can be found in the PDW category. You should also note that these multi-role weapons are applicable in mid-range roles now. As well as that, you can take an auto-carbine to these same ranges. These tend to have lower ammunition capacities, some maxing out at around about 24 to 30 rounds. These rounds, however, are larger, higher density, and will do more damage for every single one of them. The rate of fire by this point, however, is decreased to a moderate rate, and the low recoil does mean you can place some of these shots accurately. These are the weapons that work best at longer ranges. There's no question, though, every single one of these variants is powerful. It's just powerful in different kinds of roles. A weapon such as the Cydonia AR-3 will be much more applicable in mid-range than a Sahara AR-3. Having said that, if you go up against a Sahara at point-blank range, you should most certainly not expect to win if you have a Cydonia. There is no perfect auto rifle for any of these roles. There are going to be marginal differences in every single fight that tilt the advantage in one single weapon's way. Having said that, you can tilt the odds in your favor sometimes. With multi-role rifles, sometimes this is harder to judge, but generally speaking, if you have a solid aim, you'll be able to win any fight. If I'm going to advise you to take anything out of these three categories, it would be a multi-role. But again, my recommendations could change given buffs and nerfs and changes that could happen over time in the game. Next up, let's consider some perks that one can pick up for auto rifles, starting with your tier 1 upgrades. Cascade is a melee upgrade that means whenever you kill someone with a melee, it will increase the reload speed of your weapon. This is a key skill for CQC builds. Meanwhile, something like Counterbalance will increase your weapon's stability. Generally speaking, this is a very useful upgrade for PDWs, although all weapons will benefit from this, even if it is only marginally. Feeding Frenzy is one for an aggressive playstyle, meaning that kills with this weapon will reduce the reload speed of your weapon for a short time. It's particularly useful with carbines given their lower ammunition capacity, as is Focused Fire, given that when you zoom in, your weapon will fire slower but deal additional damage. And this plays to the strength of carbines that fire at longer ranges more effectively. Glass half full means that you'll be able to cause more damage with the bottom half of your magazine. It's generally applicable. But again, carbines may be able to reach this higher damage limit better. Grenadier is a perk that works interestingly with control and grenade-based builds, but is not generally synergizing with any one kind of rifle. Reactive reload, on the other hand, means that things such as PDWs, the Sahara, etc. will be able to gain huge bonuses given that these weapons reload regularly. Another thing that benefits PDWs is Hipfire, a perk that allows you to gain accuracy when you fire from the hip, particularly useful in close-quarters situations. Life support is another one that means if you are near death, you will be granted bonus ammunition and increased reload speed. It's a marginal benefit, but it can most certainly save your life in tough situations. Rangefinder is generally good, given that aiming down your weapon and increasing its effective range means that at longer range targets you will do more damage. For carbines and multi-role rifles, this is particularly good. Rodeo is almost unnecessary for PDWs with higher recoil, given that it will reduce the weapon's recoil as a direct benefit. Spray and Play, on the other hand, is better for weapons with lower magazine sizes, given that you'll be able to reload faster when your mag is empty, and you're more likely to empty the mag if it empties quicker, and thus has less bullets. Take a Knee is an interesting perk, but not necessarily good in any respect, unless you're moving to take your role as a much more long-range class. Unflinching, on the other hand, is something that is almost incredibly useful in every situation. It's easier to aim down sights when you're under fire with this weapon. Next up comes our rare and legendary perks for tier 1. And for this, we have Persistence, which is available in legendary and in rare perks. This means that your weapon will grow more accurate for the longer time being fired. Next up, a perk that can only be acquired at legendary levels, is Outlaw. Now this means that precision kills with a weapon will dramatically increase your reload speed. For a carbine-like weapon, this is particularly useful, given that you're able to get more headshots. Weapons with higher and much less manageable recoil will lose out when they have Outlaw as a perk. Having said that, it may be worth equipping, given that legendaries, generally speaking, are more stable. And finally, an unusual and often not very beneficial perk known as Who's Next. Useful for hand cannons, given that the final round in your magazine will increase your reload speed if you get a kill with it, but generally speaking, you will not be getting kills with the last round in your magazine. You tend to get a kill about a third of the way through it, which means this perk has minimal use. Next up at tier 2, which is only accessible for rares and legendaries, we have several more perks, starting off with Fitted Stock, which is a straight-up buff to the weapon's stability. Good for any weapon, particularly those working within closer quarters that require more weapon stability and less recoil. Look out for this on any kind of rare PDW. Next up comes Skip Rounds, which gives you ceramic jacket rounds that will ricochet off of harder surfaces. This, however, does slow down your reloads and general weapon handling, but the compactness of the rounds does also mean that you can carry more of them in reserve, particularly good if you're going to go out on a patrol in the wild, but for the Crucible this is less necessary. On top of that, we have Fitted Stock, which extends the effective range of the weapon. This paired with Rangefinder means that you can actually extend a carbine-like weapon's range into that of something like a scout rifle. A terrifying thought when you think about how far scout rifles can fire, but you would need a good scope to acquire targets at that range as well. Next up, single point sling, which means that you'll switch weapons faster, but you also move much quicker while you're aiming. This, of course, is wonderful for classes that skirt between different ranges regularly. Something that works between mid and close quarters range may find some real benefit from an auto rifle with single point sling and a shotgun or fusion rifle as their secondary. Next up, tier 2 legendary perks include Perfect Balance, which gives your weapon extremely low recoil. Obviously, this is a good perk. Better, I'm sure, than Counterbalance as well. Next up is Lightweight, which means that when held, the weapon in question grants 2+ to character's agility. And this is incredible for those that wish to use it in a much more mobile role. Yet again, we get Single Point Sling, which of course does the exact same thing at this level as well. Faster weapon switches and faster movement while aiming down sights. Next up though, a new perk, Flared Magwell, which allows a buff to reload speed universally. This is an incredible perk, but at the same time I feel like there are better ones out there depending on which weapon you use. Next up is Hammerforged, generally something good for something like a multi-role rifle, which improves the range and accuracy of the weapon. And finally, armor-piercing rounds. These iridium core rounds overpenetrate their targets, meaning you can hit multiple individuals with a single bullet, but their mass also slows down your reloads and general weapon handling. Beware when equipping these guardians, they have a hefty risk, but also a hefty reward. Next up, tier 3 perks, which are only available to legendary weapons. Starting off with life support, again the same as it was before. Of course, it will allow you to recover from near-death situations with increased reload speeds and additional ammunition. Now these are most certainly useful perks, but there are others in this category that one can also consider. Again, making a return is reactive reload, and the perk is unchanged. Having said that, having this with multiple other perks that require reload synergy in tow, such as another life support in tier 1, may indeed benefit the weapon immeasurably. Imagine pairing this with something like Outlaw, and then focusing on getting precision kills. Next up, we have Spray and Play, not Spray and Pray. This increases the reload speed of the weapon when its mag is empty, just as it did before. Unchanged yet again, and still not necessarily most useful perk, given that you will be able to kill someone with just over half your magazine remaining. Finally, a new perk, Third Eye, allows your radar to remain active while you're aiming down your sights. An incredibly powerful perk for any weapon using in the mid-range. Having said that, this is less useful in CQC, given that if you are facing these opponents at such close ranges, the likelihood is that they're already on top of you. Having said that, it's still a choice that is always worth considering when you pick this up. Next up, with regards to sights, the decision is truly yours. Honestly, I have some advice for you, but there is nothing I can really do to recommend one sight over the other 100% of the time. The decision is also something completely and utterly personal. One person may prefer aiming down one sight 100% of the time, even if it is suited to a certain situation over another. First up though, in terms of CQC sights, I recommend the Red Dot OAS, which allows enhanced target acquisition. And also, if you're looking for something a little bit more snappier in terms of handling, I'd recommend the Red Dot OES. The Red Dot OAS is lighter and allows for faster reloads, but the OAS has clearer sights and allows for generally faster target acquisition. For the mid-range, I recommend the Focused Lens, or FLS2. This allows you to reach out for longer targets that would generally speaking beat you, such as pulse rifle or scout rifle users. The Sure Shot IS is also generally a good sight, nice and clear, and allows you to take out targets at range with some ease and precision, given that it has an excellent reticule. And finally, the Red Dot OES. A favorite, this square sight is more often than not the most often seen, if it is even available in the perk tree. Next up, in long-range sights though, I recommend the large and often bulky Red Dot ORS sight. Finally, following that up though, I'd recommend the Ranged Lens RLS3. This is really the sight that you want to be taking if you're pushing out to the maximum range of an auto rifle. Carbine users will have some serious fun with this one. In all fairness, there is no good build for any weapon. In fact, there is no perfect build for anything in Destiny, but there are a few that I can recommend that use auto rifles particularly well. Starting off with Warlocks, each of these builds that you will see in front of you is available on my channel, and they will be updated and uploaded at some point in the future, but you should generally speaking be looking to use them at mid-range and close quarters. Voidwalkers will be able to use this effectively in a mid-range control build that I'm recommending, and Firesingers will be able to use this in a CQC flame tank build. Next up though, for those looking to take a jump into the Crucible with a Gunslinger, the Knife Juggler build is pretty good, but those looking to take on anything with a Blade Dancer should be looking at an AoE mobility build, taking into account anything that allows you to zip across the map is useful, and auto rifles fit into this nicely. And finally, Titans, you should be looking for something that breaches into the mid-range, particularly if you're using the Striker Codex. There are several mid-range control builds that I could recommend, but you could also consider a CQC charge build as well. For those using the Defender Codex, I'd recommend a tankier Brawl build that relies on the Disintegrate melee a lot more. All of these builds and more are viable. You can click any of the links on screen and I'll take you to a video where I have one of the builds displayed. The idea for an automatic rifle is almost as old as conventional warfare itself. Having said that, the idea behind different wars will always change. The one thing that is permanent, perhaps, is the soldiers that wield them. Remember this, Guardians. Particularly when you're taking yourself into the frontier or the Crucible, the weapon itself is important, but is not always paramount. The important factor is the Guardian that wields it. You must be the sure shot. You must be the one Deadeye that will end all others. This is your main objective when using any weapon. And despite the flurry of bullets that might exit from an auto rifle, your aim should still be steady and true. Take this into account, Guardians. Never underestimate your foe, and perhaps one day, consistency and accuracy will come back to reward you.